What up guys, this is Cybot here. For today's video, as you can see, I have the HJC RPHA11 on my head and I have the chin mount. Yeah, the chin mount is finally done by Bluepin Garage as usual. It's a custom one and this video is going to be talking all about this custom mount. So let's get started. HJC RPHA11, if you're interested on this helmet, go check out the review. I have it on a different video, it's on the channel. Getting straight to it, for this custom mount, well, before I did the custom mount, I actually tried to just do a normal chin mount install with the 3M GoPro adhesive, but for some reason it just didn't work out and I'll tell you why. Before I go on further, I must tell you that to install the chin position here, you are definitely going to have a chance of damaging your chin vent slider, the piece that goes up and down on the front when you remove it, because it's very delicate. So if you are not ready to have a risk of damaging it, don't try this. Otherwise, if you are okay with it, then definitely continue watching. As usual, there are other ways of mounting cameras on your RPHA11. You can mount it on the side and route it to the front, but the weight distribution is still going to be to the left or off-center. You have your typical side mount, which is not my favorite, and top mount, which is also not my favorite type of views. So when I tried to use the 3M adhesive after removing the slider, I found that after you remove the slider, the surface behind the slider was not actually a flat surface. It was flat, but it wasn't like having no contours, so there was like nooks and crannies which when you put the 3M on it, it just didn't want to stick properly or securely. I tried it a few times, I used Sugru, I used different configurations of doing the 3M stick, but it just couldn't have enough adhesion. So after a few frustrating attempts, which I initially thought was going to be something simple, ended up pissing myself off and I got to Bluepin Garage and had Joe do this custom mount for me. Now the mount itself is made out of aluminium, it has the male tripod adapter, so it's going to be actually the same as my AGV pistol, which if you have seen that video before, it's roughly the same concept. We're using the GoPro tripod adapter mount to install it onto this custom mount, and then you can install any action camera that has the GoPro adapters. So it's very simple, looks very good to me. And for myself, because definitely I'm not going to be removing this mount, so I told Joe to actually go ahead and use industrial strength glue to stick this mount to the helmet. So it's definitely not coming off, it's super solid, super strong. And that's the way I want it to be, so it's okay for me. Even though I have to sacrifice the front chin vents, but that's done deal for me. I did some high speed runs with the mount, as you can see in the later part of the video. And I would say that it's definitely stable. Of course, with the modifications in aerodynamics, you do have some wobbles, but it's not something that I would say is a deal breaker for me, which I totally cannot ride fast on this. So once again guys, if you're interested for this type of mount that I'm featuring for you right now, you can get in touch with Joe at Bluepin Garage. I'll leave a link on the description in the video here. Alright guys, so this is going to be the visor demo for you. Right now the visor is up. To close the visor, just do the normal, push it down and lock it. Visor is locked. So to open it, it's very simple. For myself, I just pinch the edge of the tab and lift it up. Right, one more time. Locked. Open. So with the mount, it's still having a good clearance to open and close the visor, even if we're on the bike. So I don't find an issue for that. Alright guys, so right now we are doing about 160-170 kilometers per hour. I'm doing head checks. Definitely feeling stable. I'm not tucked in behind the windscreen and the helmet is very stable right now. No issues on that. For the GoPro attachment itself, as you can see, I'm spotting three parallel adapters for the GoPro, and the reason that I'm using three is because I wanted to make the camera at a lower position from the chin so that it has clearance for the visor, so that we can open and close the visor without any issues. and also get a better angle if you want to tilt it more extreme if you're really doing those hard races and you want to grab all the viewing angles, then you can actually tilt it back more. So that's the purpose that I'm using three GoPro parallel adapters. The next part of this video is actually going to be talking about setting up your RPHA11 for motovlogging, or basically a microphone so you can talk crap and curse at people like what I do on a daily basis, more or less. For myself, I'm still sporting the same microphone, which is a stereo microphone, left and right, so it's a quite huge microphone, and I have it right dead center of where my mouth is and my nose is. Because of the shell size of the RPHA11 is quite compact, so the microphone is actually quite close to myself. So yeah, I do have a microphone stock on it, but it has to be tapered down to make it a bit thinner. Otherwise, it's definitely mushing onto my lips and nose, and it's a very tight space right now. But for me, it's still alright because I did some mods to it and made the microphone stock thinner, like I said, so there's more room for me. As usual, the routings of the external microphone cables are all over inside the liner, behind the liners. And I do have the chin curtain on. Yeah, it's not removed, I kept it on. So in order to route the cables from inside the helmet to outside the helmet, I actually needed to make a hole on the chin curtain to push the cable through. And speaking about other mods, well, as you can see, these front chin vents here are also covered up. They are black color stickers, tinted black right now. So I did this actually to reduce wind noise. If you're not going to be doing motovlogging, I don't think you need to cover all these holes up. The inner part of the slider, there's an inside switch as well to open and close the vents. I also taped that part up. And the front settings is the same. I have my Hero 4 on. You can see the external cables, the USB microphone adapter, the usual stuff. So this is the setup for motovlogging, and I find that it's performing pretty good. So all in all, I have to say that I'm damn pleased with this mount. I'm going to be wearing this helmet more often in the future. And so we'll definitely get a good run out of our money for this custom mount setup. My blooping garage and also my motovlog setup so that I can talk shit and curse and swear. The joys of being a biker, right? So guys, that's gonna be it for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. And till the next one guys, this is Cyborg here. Ride safe and safe ride.